place the four corners on one base. That means I'm going to put some notes on the base. I'm going to place another point for the load. Okay, I'm good to go now. Here, first of all, I need to set the path. That means I'm going to set the working folder for this run. I'm going to get it to each run. I'm going to tell the program which is the design domain, which is the model that we're going to optimize. And this is done by running the get solid command, get solid, and then click on the prompt here, flash. That means the program has already known that this block is the design domain. This is property, this is the model. And I'm going to add the constraint, so which is the support for the constraint. I'm going to include all the whole points. And then I'm going to fix them, fix four points, and fix X direction, fix Y direction. Okay, then now you have four fixed points at one surface, and I'm going to get one. We have a 3D editor here, fixed on corners at one surface and one load at the middle of the other surface. And before we run the PSO, we need to set the property. That means set the material property and set the size of one element. And then, 2% of the ratio is good to me. I live here, 3, as the part of the radius is also good. And I'm going to get a quick run. So that's why I'm going to reduce the yes? Now, run. Okay, you see here in the command line here, you see that the mesh is going on. The mesh is finished now, and the user 3D program has been called. Background is running now. And in the meantime, we don't need to wait. wait in the end and see the solution. We actually, we can see the intermediate designs. There are two kinds of methods, two kinds of approaches you can see in the intermediate design. The first one is read elements. That means we read every element as one single object into the Rhino. And that means you are going to read a lot of objects, a lot of bodies into the Rhino. That will take some time. And the second approach you are going to read in intermediate design is to read the skin, only read the outer surface. You're not going to read every element. And that will save a lot of time. I'm going to try the screen function. And I believe the solution is in here, in a temp function, in the temp folder. You see here? Okay, the run has already finished. It's quite quick. I can see, show you the, okay, that's the intermediate design of the iterations. Oh, I can show you some earlier intermediate design, like the third one. Oh, sorry, I need to move this away so that you will not be confused. I'll read the first one. Okay, the first. Okay, see here. That's the result. That's the intermediate design of the first iteration, and that is the intermediate design of the 19th iteration. Okay, that's how you can read the design, how you read the result back to the Rhino. And you can do some rendering, you can do some modification on the solutions, like this moving. I'll show you some quick, simple one. Python moves. And you put a random number here. Is it here? This object has been a little bit out of surface. It's not anymore as exact shape. The surface has been a little bit smooth. You can go on smoothing this structure by right click. Continue to repeat the previous action. Okay, another one. It's a bit more smooth. Continue. Okay. I think I'm done here. This is how you use this plugin. This is how you can take advantage of the.